Oh, there we go.
Huh?
A million years.
Now, we'll come back to that later.
Not in a million.
So, here's the goofiest part. I actually really got a kick out of that joke because it's so on the nose.
Yeah.
I think it's hilarious.
Yeah.
I actually ended up turning against the joke by the end of the game because the joke isn't even honest.
I mean, if they went along and had a moment, too, where, like, he runs by a department store and sees a red jacket and goes, ew.
But you know what I mean? Like,
I do.
And we will get back to that near the end of the LP.
I was going to say, how much do you want to say? Yeah, exactly.
The joke is not even honest.
Which it retroactively gets worse. That's it's funny because it's like...
Goodbye.
It's like it's the thing that how do I put this?
Like, I have so many complex feelings about this game.
So it's the same place where your strengths are, no matter how wrong you are, you stand by them until you drown, until the boat sinks. You stand there crossing your arms, going "fuck the world."
Yeah,
And,
oh no, that was not smooth at all.
And I'm a person who will say "fuck the world," and then when the water gets about, you know, not ankle deep, but it hits my waist, and I'm be like, "okay, give me the life raft."
Yeah, you'll say,
and then
I'll
be like, "can we?"
No. What you'll say is, "you know what, world? We'll have to agree to disagree.
Can we find can we find a life raft where you know I." Can we work this out some way, right? I'm trying to find out your point of view. You want me drowned, and I'm trying to tell you to fuck off. Maybe we can come to a compromise where I only half drown. And that level of ooh, there you go. And so what happens is when this game has a moment like that where it
wants to have it both ways.
It has a thesis statement, right?
Oh no, I'm doing a bad job.
I like to call it the Babe Ruth moment, pointing at the stands, calling out your home run.
Yeah.
And then you run it back.
And then you bunt. That's how I feel this game ends.
It's not a good look.
This game...
It's not a good look.
So you know what? Let's make our thesis statement. This is a game in which the development team did everything they could to try and differentiate it from the old series, only to invariably end up copying the old series and making a somewhat weak facsimile of a bunch of its aspects.
And the
which was like the stupidest way they could have possibly gone.
Because the biggest disservice you could do to what is an otherwise decent game is create a comparison point that doesn't need to be there.
Like, just...
But Capcom and, of course... You know, like, the budget wouldn't have been what it was if it was an original thing. Like, there's a million logistical things that would have changed if this were an original new property. Mm-hmm. But the point remains that all we're really talking about this whole time is comparison points that didn't need to be there.
Son of Sparta.
Son of who?
You have been found. You are dead. Just like your mother.
Poor mother. I don't know my mother, but if you're calling me a son of a bitch, you wouldn't be the first.
So that's a really good example. The shot we just saw.
Yeah.
They want to get away from the old games, but then they simultaneously recreated the Devil May Cry 3 box art with that pose.
With the pose, yeah.
My mother.
And it's like, wait, which do you want? Remember.
Yeah.
Do you want to?
Well, I mean, we're looking at the necklace.
So, like, step one. Of like, I was worried about this game from a reboot. I came in on this, or at least I tried to, as objective as possible. Step one of me being worried is that Mudnus was the villain. If you were gonna reboot it completely, you have a completely fucking fresh slate. The only thing you want to bring over is Dante. It is a bummer that it is a weird alternate universe retelling of the first game.
Well, I was gonna say, like, I feel like the answer to that question is, like, they wanted a stiff, okay, hard reboot in the sense that all the pieces exist, right? And we want you to have things that you recognize moving in ways that you don't expect.
I didn't ask for your help.
So recognition
is part of what you're supposed to have going into this.
In a weird way, this is almost like the game is trying to be, to Devil May Cry, like The Force Awakens. We just want to do A New Hope again, but let's do it different, our way this time.
But you recognize the pieces.
So probably we're going to talk about this over and over, and we're probably going to repeat ourselves.
Wonderful.
The look of this game is often spectacular. The tone of this game aged so badly. The tone is edgelord. It is just straight up edgy teenager. I mean, they got Combi Christ doing the fucking soundtrack, right?
Yeah.
And I feel like it was dated before it came out.
Although,
like, that style had already passed.
Bob is still as relevant as ever.
Oh, yeah, it's hilarious. But, you know what I mean? Like, and now, looking back at it today, it is, like, laughably edgy. Like, I feel like this Dante would feel right at home chilling with fucking Shadow the Hedgehog. You know?
I'm gonna go slightly different on that and say that this game is still cool to people that don't play video games.
Okay, yeah, all right. That, I see what you're doing.
Right?
I know.
Your entire target.
Turbo mode, just right on there, right there.
There's an entire group of people that is a target that.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dark Dante.
Neo
Dante.
The people that would just be like, this is the people that don't play video games.
Not in a million years.
Multiple outfits, too.
Not in a million years.
Yeah.
You start the game and every outfit other than the default has fucking white hair. Of course it does. All right. Let's get going.
I got the change list.
All right.
Oh, yeah. These loading screens. These are cool.
These are great.
Yeah. Little combo examples.
They're legitimately fantastic. They're supposed to show people, like,
what you're supposed
to
do.
Hey, look, you
what
can
a fight
do
should
this.
Look like. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now,
yeah,
Wooly, you're scrolling through on your phone. It's a lot.
It's big.
It's actually, like, far too much to really go into
in depth.
So I would highly suggest anyone who has the nitty gritty kind of desire to
welcome
go look up the definitive edition of DMC Devil May Cry change list. Just
and
an enormous amount of balance changes.
And the mode you're talking about is hardcore mode.
Hardcore mode, yeah. I didn't even see that
HCM.
On the
phone. HCM. We're fighting back. So Cat over here
works for Anonymous.
New Chicky Poo. We're a small handful of freedom fighters. We are
the last and only line of defense. Defense.
And you know what? To this Dante's credit, we didn't spend step one of the game of him going, mother.
No.
In fact, he doesn't even know his mom.
We can hit them where it hurts.
So this is where the underground is spouting dank memes at CEO Man in order to defeat them. Oh, look, there's the not Anonymous mask. It's not a Guy Fawkes mask.
It's not a Guy Fawkes mask. It's not a V for Vendetta.
I was talking to Wooly about this.
Amazing.
They actually fucking removed Virgil's fedora from the game.
That's pretty. That's a fucking crazy patch.
They just straight up removed it entirely from the game.
Now, here's the other thing. Is the opportunity to retell this story from the origin point means that you can work Virgil in from the beginning.
It's
in
day
a way,
one.
Which, in a way which makes more sense.
Or mission two, as
how much
it were.
Of your childhood do you remember?
You know, that's a decent ability.
Not much.
That's
I
a decent move.
When I was 7, wiped my memory. Why? They told me I had a car accident that resulted in total amnesia. Age 7.
Wow.
Your point?
That's so deep.
But here, like, look at the mocap here. Like, this is a pretty,
absolutely.
Pretty natural Dante. Conversation. And
it's shame the writing doesn't keep up with it.
With deception, and you have been deceived.
Your past has been hidden from you for a
like
reason.
Eye tracking, little face, little expressions. You know, nothing in the original Devil May Cry is like plays out that way.
I remember when we all saw the first design of Virgil, the Virgil that's walking around right now. The first thing that popped in my head is like, I like that redesign way better.
We use force
than Dante's.
We also use
yes.
Politics. He's wearing a coat.
Oh yeah, I was down. I was down on it. I was totally down with it.
Make a dent. With the two of us,
and it's the American version of the prep hairstyle.
Absolutely,
so that's right? That's what this is about. You need me to fight the demons, help you save the world.
Like punk versus prep in anime world is what you get in with Dante and Virgil that we know. And this is the total Western version of punk versus prep.
Work alone, that kind of thing.
Which is dirty versus I take a bath.
I don't think you understand what is at stake.
Socias and greasers.
If you want to leave,
you have like emo goth. Me, I'm powerless. Scene
on the side.
Cat, whatever she is, she's
scene girl. Scene girl on the side.
Not just for yourself, but for mankind.
For mankind.
Yes.
What makes you think I give a shit?
Oh, that's edgy. Please give me a chance to show you.
Show me what?
Who you really are.
Yeah. So, natural conversations, facial expressions.
Oh, God, I forgot. I mean, that's just really on the nose, isn't it?
Well, I mean, there's that, but there's also the part where, like, there is a little bit of mother.
Oh, yeah, there is. There is a little, just a tiny little...
But it's almost a little bit more like, hey, Ma!
Hey, Ma, where's the pizzas? Can I get a pizza? God damn it, Ma.
The dual color jacket made me feel like taking cues from Nero more than Dante.
Huh.
Is what I my first impression was, too.
Also, I really like this idea.
Mm-hmm.
Of it's
spray paint sigils.
It's way faster to do it like this.
Yeah.
Our world and Limbo are very closely superpositioned. They collide in places, causing what
it's that it's we that SMT demon summoning app levels of tech. Like, oh, what does it take?
I'll just fucking spray paint
these ingredients. This summoning, this ritual, cool.
Digitize that.
Automate it.
Now they don't have Stephen Hawking here.
Smell too good
to create an app for this.
A compound I created based on an old Wiccan recipe. Sea salt, shark oil, iron shavings, desiccated squirrel semen, wolf hair.
Good stuff.
Go ahead. The house holds secrets. I found mine. Now it's your turn.
Hell, I get back.
We'll take care of that. Just be careful. It can get rough on you.
I like it rough.
Right. You know, delivery. He's little, he's little.
Is this really going to work? He doesn't seem to care.
He's raw. Just like you were when I first found you.
These film, or should I say cinematic quality touches, even though that word is not in the hottest spotlight right now. How do you feel about that, by the way?
How do I feel about what, exactly?
Cinematic as a descriptor for video games is annoying because it keeps comparing video
I can't
games
stand it.
To not video
I'm,
games.
I'm very tired of it.
And it's like, the medium doesn't have to always challenge itself by being compared to another medium.
I don't particularly feel like games should be aspiring to be movies.
Yep, there you go. There you go.
Even the best movie-style game is still not a movie. Should probably focus on being a game first.
If only gameplay and cutscenes could come together with some sort of quick timed event.
That's also a problem in and of itself.
If only there was a way.
You know what the weirdest thing about quick time events is? Mm-hmm. Is that name is a misnomer because it's easier to say and sounds better to the ear. The actual name of them is Quick Timer Events.
Oh,
in Shenmue.
Shenmue and Dynamite Cop.
I don't know about Dynamite Cop, but in Shenmue, which I believe was the first
I
one.
I think Dynamite Deku came first.
Okay, well, the phrase came from Yu Suzuki.
Yeah.
Wait, was it
Yu Suzuki? It was that team.
Saying Quick Timer Events.
Yeah.
Actually makes more sense considering they give a literal timer on the screen. Oh no, I'm lost.
I'll always remember when James told me about, like, in one of those later Tomb Raider games. I want to say it was like Underworld or
Man, how am I gonna open it? I don't know.
where you see the camera cut to like a dramatic angle, and then a big Indiana Jones boulder starts rolling behind her.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're waiting for the quick timer prompt, and then it's like, nah, idiot, actually run.
I remember
and
this
And it's like,
place.
Oh, that's cool. You made a QTE moment, but you still have to play it.
That game also has the issue of it shows you what is ostensibly gameplay, but the only thing that works is the forward stick movement.
Mm.
In which point, it might as well be a fucking cutscene. Well,
there is that. Yeah, no, this was a free movement point that he was describing.
And who the hell are you?
CBT.
Hey, look, it's Sparta.
Sparta?
Son of Sparta.
My dad.
Look at the big Bugman stuff.
Great.
Wow, they really came in fast. They didn't even get a transition.
Hey, what does this game sound like in Japanese? I wonder.
Probably the same.
I'd be curious. I never looked into it. So Drive is so much faster.
It's real fucking fast.
That it's like they want you to use it a whole lot. And I think Overdrive, actually.
Yeah, Overdrive is the one I actually want. Regular Drive is pretty weak sauce.
Yeah. But it comes out very frequently.
Wait, well, hey, look at you! What's your deal?
No Arbiter yet, right?
You're up next.
No, I got nothing. Oh, wow, look at you.
Tough guy.
So what we're not going to be seeing, and we joked about it a little earlier, but... Oh, God, no, it's still too early for that. Never mind.
Don't worry about it, man.
I forget when stuff happens.
How many times you beat this?
Did I play it after the first one?
I did it twice.
No, I did it the first time, and then I did...
No, wait, I didn't. I only did the once.
Yeah, I did it. I did the normal playthrough, and then I did the DLC.
I fucked around with it, with the DE when it came out, but I never beat that.
Yeah, I didn't. But I remember hearing enough about it, and talked a lot about it with Shmup God as well.
You get the vast majority of your moveset in this game really fucking fast.
Or you see it really fast. So here you go. There you go.
I have half the game's moveset.
There's the other.
Now, it does have a pretty interesting, mechanical distinction here, where you hold the triggers to change between your weapons.
Yes. Angel weapon, demon weapon.
Instead of switching them.
Not so tough now.
If you can do that really heavy third axe switch strike that does the cool thing.
Yeah, I don't have that right now.
Okay. It's another awesomely stylish piece of detail that they put into the game. To its credit. But yeah, so there you go. Now
I have heavies.
And you have a red weapon and a white weapon, or a blue weapon, I should say.
Yeah, blue.
And alongside this comes the introduction that would have been enemies that are only weak to certain colors.
Oh, God.
Therefore, the ability... So, like, the stylus combos that require weapon switching do not apply because this enemy only gets hurt by this type of weapon. So, take the idea that Blitz... I think, like, would convey, but completely miss what you actually get out of that. Where there's no clean opening moment, you just have color-coded things, which means you're just weapon limited and style limited, and therefore gameplay limited.
Of every change or design decision they made in this game, by far the most reviled, without question, is the addition of the color-coded enemies. Which actually don't show up for like 6 more levels.
Is that the case? Okay.
Yeah, they don't show up for a fucking long time.
Well, then it's the first thing I think of when I see the axe.
In the Son of Sparta mode that you unlock afterwards, they show up in that room, I believe. But they are awful. In a series that's all about hot weapon switching.
Yep.
They fucking
gimp
just
you.
Gimp the shit out of you.
No fun allowed here.
And say, Hey, you know these movesets were actually pretty decently designed to all work in tandem?
You got a point.
You are now down to one third, and neither of which are your main weapon.
And you're gonna have both kinds in the room at the same time.
I'm gonna have to replay some of these missions off camera, because, this has a Metroidvania-style progression in that you cannot... You straight up cannot get all of them.
You got a point, by the way.
I know. I just don't have access to the statue of time to get through here. Yeah, way faster. Holy shit.
Battle music, nowhere near as catchy as it used to be.
Oh, yeah. And I was trying to say earlier...
Still better than Subhuman.
I'm glad I played it on the PC first, because the console version of this broke with series tradition and was the only one that ran at 30 FPS.
60 was PC only.
Yes. Which was very disappointing for a lot of reasons. It altered a lot of gameplay design decisions that are honestly a little too subtle for me to even get correct ever. But the game's feel was necessarily different because of the input leniency required.
Now that childhood moment is totally canon.
It's canon.
We heard it.
You saw it. Hey, look at that. I got Arbiter now. So, I don't know about you, Wolves. But I talked about this. Maximum amount of moves before going for power.
Yeah, that's the smart way to do it.
Right, so that's the stinger. It's a projectile. Mm-hmm. Isn't that weird?
Now, is it this? Is it Trinity Smash?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's yeah. it. That's it. Yeah.
But I'm actually going to go for... Yeah, I'm going to go for Trinity Smash. So it's bop, bop. This game actually does something... that more action games should do for beginners, and it's also useful for everybody. As you see, right? It's cool little sword flashes that show you the impact point.
Mm-hmm.
But if you go pop, pop, you also see the highly specific timing for your pauses. Hit it when it shines. Simple.
Do it again.
It.
Do it with the sword. There, the shine.
Yeah, see that?
Okay.
It even has a sound effect.
Completely didn't catch that.
Oh, yeah?
Or if I did, I don't remember it.
It's great. Legitimately great little detail.
Smart.
Oh, look at that. Look at that video game shit. I do not know if I want to keep going with the fucking double tap stinger shit.
Yeah? At this point in my brain says
so far,
hold button and sting.
So far,
and
it has only resulted in accidental stingers.
Because, it's just conditioning, you know? Like, why, It's just conditioning.
Now, it obviously needed that in the original because the
camera, yeah.
Unbelievable. Hey, wait a second. I just got a red thing for real, oh my god. I must be able to get a goddamn... No. That's the move you're talking about, I assume.
Yeah, the camera zoom in. The camera zoom in is a really nice effect. And they also kept... You know, Itsuno super kept the final slash slowdown because he liked it.
Yes, it should be mentioned, and this is kind of sad to me, that not all of the credit for this game's strengths can actually be levied against Ninja Theory, because Itsuno showed up to work on the game mid-development and helped them fine-tune tons of shit, including stuff like the stinger animation. Enemy design and such.
So, you know, he knows enough to know that, like, that when I go on stage, I'm gonna say, like, for fans.
I remember this.
There's an interview where he talks about how he saw an enemy design that had blade elbows. And he said, oh, that's cool. How are they gonna cut Dante with those? And the designer said, well, he's not. It's just to look cool. And Itsuno replies, well, then take them off. That's stupid. Oh, Oh, here we go. Here's one of the first fucking screenshots that came out of the game. Was this location. Why? Because it's fucking cool looking.
Because it looks like a concept art painting.
You know what bums me out about the fact that this is so cool looking? That it uses such, like, it's one of those things is when you see it, it's ruined for you. Half the reason why this place is so visually striking is they just use movie box art color logic and just make everything cyan and cyan and orange.
Yes, the opposite colors of each other. But it's, I mean, the silly thing about that though is that yes, you can call it that movie box art logic, but it's more than that. It's basic color theory in art.
Let me try this again. It is overdone in the film industry.
It is.
Where shit will be color corrected to absurdity.
But the deal is that what you don't realize is that throughout life, all the time in more subtle ways and just not realizing it.
Totally.
There's an entire thing called color theory.
Oh, I'm aware.
You know?
But...
Where you work with complementary and contrasting colors.
This gray stone has somehow been changed. Look, gray stone is... just orange in most light.
Warm hues stand up nice against cold hues. It's you know.
And that's how you dress yourself.
I mean, no, but...
Well, no, I'm making fun of something you said earlier. Maybe 6 months ago. Where you talked about complementary colors, and then you said, and that's how I dress myself.
Oh, yeah, right. Earth tones, don't worry about it. Keep it simple. No! It is funny and true to point out that like it's overused.
This looks like a fucking sci-fi direct-to-video.
And the version in particular is when you see man standing with warm colors on one side and cold colors on the opposite.
Oh, that one's just
right. Like it is, but there is a level of it where it's like yes, but also you know everything does this, and it's literally like some of the basis of what makes art appealing. You know. Like, it's like pointing out the line of action, for example, as something that, you know, once you see it in a lot of good art, you'll see it everywhere, especially in comics and stuff. But, like, that chain that goes off into the distance, for example, you'll want to put the camera in a place where your eye will naturally travel around the screen until it gets to the beginning of the chain and follows to an ending point. So, in theory... there's a maze that you design the screen to have so that if you were to start out at the edge of where this camera, that building is,
yeah.
You'd do a little spiral, then come back up at the top and end at his chin.
So I'd like to talk about a system thing that I just rediscovered. Mm-hmm. So this game does not have dodge offset, which is a complicated topic for a Bayonetta playthrough.
Here's
the
simple
future.
Version. When you do combos,
so
if you dodge in between, the combo will keep going, so she does the moves later in the combo.
This has something somewhat... I think I might even prefer it. Or it has inter-weapon combo memory? I don't know what to call it. Because, so you have... This is your pause combo for Rebellion. Yes?
Yes.
This is your pause combo for Arbiter.
Yes.
However... If you time it correctly and just let go of the R2 button, you can switch between the two pause combos.
And continue in the place where they left off?
Yep. So you can go bop bop and then straight to the ender from that. Which is really useful and pretty cool.
I mean, when you pretty much decide to design a game around angel button, devil button, you can play with left and right like that. That's
you know all sorts of cool stuff. Suck it, chain.
Now, do you have a preference for, like, weapon style switching to be, like, on triggers versus D-pads?
Well, style switching has to be on the D-pad for obvious weapons and reasons. I would like the ability to choose between a trigger hold and a trigger press, depending on how many weapons you want to equip.
So what else have you got?
But If you have...
more than two.
If you have two only,
yeah.
Give me a press.
Yeah.
If you have three, give me a hold. If you have more than that, give me a press. So, for more situations, press just works.
Because, like, Virgil, you know, you're, like, you're swapping between three, so you always...
It's awkward. I wish it was just a regular-ass, a hold, honestly.
I don't mind it. I don't mind it.
Of course not. We're used to it.
Yeah, what you're holding is not what is on either side.